So my daughter went to St. Joseph's Hospital the other day, and she was on something, and they discharged her again. So let me talk to you about this hospital, and I want to save you people time to not go to this hospital because St. Joseph's in Paterson, New Jersey, the front of the emergency room, when you go inside, it is congested. They do not call people on time. They treat the drug addicts. They treat the homeless people like nothing. Well, let's talk about my case. Crisis, for example. Whenever I need crisis, same scenario all the time. Well, we can't give you that much information. She's 22 years old, blah, 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 blah. Mind you, my daughter's been there in and out constantly, okay, for a couple of years now. They don't consider her mental health. No. They say, well, it's drug-related. It's not mental health. She doesn't want to kill herself and she doesn't want to kill others. Those are the two things that they look out for. First of all, she's not going to say she wants to kill herself because obviously she doesn't want to be in the hospital. She's smart enough to know, say that. Second of all, you know that she has a mental health issue. She does. She was diagnosed many times. And you're going to go ahead and you're going to say it's a drug problem. So who made that decision was the ER doctor, which was, I don't know his name, but whoever the ER doctor was there for Friday, February 8th, made that decision to let my daughter go. And he said, oh, no, she's fine. It's drug-related. Let's just write it off. Okay, time to get discharged, blah, blah, blah. And then the crisis person, I was on the phone with her for almost an hour telling her, like pleading to her, you know, she really needs help. She really needs to get stable again. Didn't matter. She called me back and said, well, you know, at this time, she doesn't want to kill herself and she's fine. She can go home. So, of course, I got upset. So, I went inside the doc. I went into the hospital and all the nurses and doctors were there. And I asked for the medical doctor, of course. He ignored me. Somebody was screaming or whatever was happening. So they decided to give them fentanyl. The nurse said, well, you know what? I'm going to give this guy fentanyl. Fentanyl, the most addictive drug that you can give a person. I don't know why they gave them fentanyl, but people are dying from fentanyl. But he's a fucking idiot. He really is. Like, he's just an idiot. There's no other way to say it. And they're really there for their paychecks. You want somebody who's sympathetic and cares, then you need to bring some money, maybe cash, and possibly give it to the staff there because that's all re they're really there for. And forget about the crisis unit because they just think too highly of themselves, especially if you get in their way, ask too many questions, or you want to find out what's going on with your loved one. Don't ask too much because they just get really annoyed right away. So be careful with that. But if you want to get help and you need help, do not go to St. Joseph's because you're going to be very disappointed. They just don't treat people nicely there. They never treated my daughter nicely there. My daughter actually says she got assaulted there by one of the security guards, which is they're under investigation for that. So that's another issue that I'm facing with the hospital. So this hospital overall is a negative 5,000, 5 million. Never had a good experience there. Never had a genuine doctor to really care about my daughter. They sometimes even skip blood work sometimes because they figure, oh, she's just high. She needs to come off of it. On the side of the emergency room, when you walk in, there are tons of, there's seats there. There's like, you know, the hospital beds. And you see there's a section where all the alcoholics and addicts on the left side, and you just see them. And it's so sad because it's like they just treat them like nothing. They don't pay mind to them. They let them sober up, and then they're just out again. So really, I have had no good experiences with this hospital. And like I said, they're just there for money. They don't want to deal with anything. They want to go in and out, drug him, make sure he's stable, and let's ship him out into the street because that's what they have to do. That's how they work in this hospital. Crisis, same thing. Ask those three questions. Does she want to kill herself? Who's the president? And do you want to harm anyone? Oh, okay. Okay, let's call your mom. You're ready to get discharged. Okay. So you're not going to consider her history. You're not going to do anything because you're too lazy to do your job. You just want everything easy. And unfortunately, a lot of these people, you know, they're educated, but they're not that educated because really, it doesn't seem to me that they're educated with anything. And really, this medical doctor, I didn't realize that you had a psychiatry degree to really diagnose to see if my daughter needs help. So thank you so much for that because you're an idiot. But of course, again, you're just there for your money. So again, just stay away from St. Joseph's in Paterson, New Jersey. Thanks.